All right, welcome back. I'm Frederica Whitfield in the nation's capital. Police in large cities are on high alert this weekend after a third night of anti-Trump protests broke out across the U.S. This is video in Los Angeles. Most of the marches and rallies were peaceful, but in Portland, Oregon, tensions exploded. One person was shot and police are still looking for the gunman. At protests in Miami, Florida, demonstrators held signs that said, "Build bridges, not walls." And in Atlanta, protesters burned an American flag outside of the state capitol. And that's where we find CNN's Polo Sandoval, who has been tracking these protests all night in Atlanta. So Polo, what more do we know about, let's go, you know, across the country over to Portland, Oregon. What more do we know about that shooting?
Right, we do understand that things went down early this morning, Fred, that there were several demonstrators that had gathered on a bridge there in Portland. At one point, an individual pulls out a gun, shots are fired, and we're told that one man was actually hit and treated for non-life-threatening injuries. But of course, the key there is that the search for a suspect here, police are still trying to track down that individual that pulled that gun. But again, that person that was hit is expected to be okay. And this followed what was a very violent night, though, there in Portland, as police clashing with some demonstrators. The mayor of the city just a couple of days ago, after seeing a similar situation like this play out on the streets of his city, said that a majority of those demonstrators have remained relatively peaceful. It is those individuals that the mayor, Charlie Hills, is called anarchists, that are really disrupting what should be peaceful demonstrations there. He's the one who says that, or at least he says that really they are the ones who are drowning out the voices of those individuals who say that there's not necessarily anything that can change about the outcome of the election. It's what they are protesting, though, are some of the policy suggestions that have been proposed by now President-elect Trump on the campaign trail. So again, people now getting ready for what could be another night of demonstrations, not just in Portland, but also in other cities across the country. Fred.
All right, Polo Sandoval, we'll check back with you as things unravel today or unwind today. All right, thank you so much. All right, up next.